Hello friends, welcome to this August edition of Monthly Viewpoints. Globally, US equity markets are at all-time highs. However, China has seen a sell-off due to regulatory action by the Chinese government on internet and edtech companies. Indian equity markets are also at all-time highs, with Nifty crossing 16,000 levels. Market has become broad-based, and the market cap of large caps as a percent of the total market cap has fallen to a three-year low. Small and mid-caps have outperformed large caps over the past 1 year, and cyclicals have outperformed defensives. The global economy has recovered strongly from the COVID pandemic. US job growth numbers as well as wage growth numbers are above expectations, and the US yields also rose in response. Although the Fed has reiterated that it is in no hurry to taper or raise rates, in bond tantrum are seen as the biggest tail risk currently. Its vaccinations are progressing well, and more than 60% of the vulnerable 45-plus age group has been vaccinated with at least one dose. Recovery from the second wave has been much faster as compared to the first wave, and the impact of the second wave has also been less than feared. Overall, India's economy should come back on track by FY23 to its trend growth of 6.5% to 7%. Consumption recovery is also on the cards. Employment trends show that the organized sector has escaped the COVID hit. However, small companies and the informal segment have suffered the brunt. IT sector hiring continues to be resilient, while the rural employment has been impacted. From an investment standpoint, the stage is set for housing recovery as the need for increased work from home has gained traction and affordability has also improved as home loan rates are at very attractive levels and property prices have remained flat for the last few years. India is on the cusp of a new multi-year capex cycle led by the government infrastructure spending. Globally, earnings have shown strong recovery. In the US, EPS growth estimates for the S&P 500 have been upgraded to more than 40% year over year. In India, FY22 earnings were upgraded earlier to 35% to 40% year over year. The Q2 earnings season is going on and the results are in line with expectations. Going forward, with the economic recovery, corporate profits are also expected to show a turnaround. For FY23, Nifty earnings growth is projected at a normalized level of around 15% year over year. Globally, the valuations elevated due to low interest rates and high liquidity. And even in India, headline valuations seem elevated currently due to the depressed earnings. However, from a medium-term perspective, valuations seem fair as the economy and earnings have normalized by then. FII flows moderated in July due to the strong USD and concerns about the Delta variant in emerging markets. However, given the high global liquidity and with the second wave having peaked out in India, we can expect FII inflows to continue. Domestic mutual fund flows have been strong over the past 3 months, and even in July, mutual funds have seen an inflow of almost 28,000 crores, driven mainly by NFOs. Increased retail participation should also support markets. Coming to our view on the market, given all the considerations discussed before, for the medium to long term, our outlook for economic and earnings growth remains positive, and we remain constructive on equities. We maintain our view to play domestic cyclicals, industrials, IT, and financials. After the recent rally, we have a cautious view on equities for the short term. Near-term upside may be limited, but any correction should also be temporary and minor. Hence, investors should remain invested in equities mainly through SIPs and use any correction as an opportunity to increase equity exposure, as the risk-reward for equities seems fairly balanced for the medium to long term. We provide a bouquet of funds for investors to choose from. Thank you and happy investing.